you're about to hear is true, but strange.
On Christmas Eve, Tom, you picked up a girl on the road and didn't even tell me about it.
Oh, wait a minute, Lucille. How did you...
She was a beautiful girl with eyes like nothing a man has ever seen before.
You've been talking to Bill?
And you end up at my house walking around as though you weren't quite connected with this world.
Answer me. Have you been talking to Bill? Did he tell you about this?
I've talked with Bill, but he didn't tell me any part of this. Neither did anyone else. But I know, and I can tell you every detail of that ride.
How?
That's why you're off for this ride, darling. I'm going to show you how.
Strange. True stories of the supernatural. With your narrator, famous author, lecturer, and expert on weird and unusual events, Walter Gibson.
Thank you, Charles Woods. At the turn of the century, a train ran through Connecticut, which local residents dubbed the Ghost Train. It was real enough at the time, but its white cars gave it a weird effect when seen through the night. In years to come, the term became even more appropriate. Years ago, Tom Lacey was driving over back roads in Connecticut to spend Christmas with his fiancée. In the rear seat, his friend Bill Bowen was dozing comfortably along with his dog Spangles. Tom didn't like the road very much.
We should have put on chains. It's pretty hard to hold this car down these old high ground roads. That sounds like a sleigh.
Where is it?
Gee, I wonder if there could be a side road running along here. But hear those bells, it's plain as day, but there's not a sign of the sleigh, either in front of us or behind us. Well, I sure hate having to stop for it in a hurry while I'm going down this long hill. There's a train coming. It's an old steam train. See, I thought everything up here was steam. There's no more bells. The sleigh must have stopped for the train, and I bet it... Whoa. White cars. It's like a ghost train. Funny. The steel didn't mention anything about the railroad crossing in the direction. There's somebody in the road, I think.
Yeah, it's a girl.
Well, there's somebody to talk to since Bill won't wake up.
Get in. You must be frozen standing out there.
Here, I'll close the door for you. Well, where to, miss?
To my house. In the valley at the foot of the long hill road. My father is ill. I must get to him right away. Right away.
Long Hill Road? I'm afraid I don't know where that is.
Take the first right down the hill. At the bottom. Take a left fork across the covered bridge. It's the first house, the other side of the river.
Okay, take it easy. I'll get you there. Well, I guess this is the place, miss.
Yes.
There's somebody waiting for you on the porch, I think, with a lantern.
My brother Leonard.
Oh. Oh, wait a minute. Let me get the door. It sticks.
Thank you.
Well, wait a minute. You don't have to be in such a hurry, do you? I kind of like to see you again.
After Christmas, I'm sure my father will be well. Good night.
Christmas at the home of Lucille Rutledge, Tom's fiancée. But Tom, oddly enough, was more quiet than usual. Although Lucille worried a little, asking if he felt all right, Tom would not admit to anything being wrong. Finally, she got Bill Boland aside to ask a few pertinent questions.
Bill, will you talk to me for a minute?
Sure, pick a subject.
I can't help wondering what's happened to Tom. Do you have any idea?
Well, I didn't know anything had happened to him.
Oh, well, now, he's not being himself at all. He's quiet. And you know that's not at all like Tom.
Come to think of it, I guess that's right.
We haven't seen each other since Thanksgiving. Are you sure that... he hasn't met another girl?
No. Look, he dragged me through every high-priced store on Fifth Avenue before we came up here. And he was like an anxious adolescent. Did I think you'd like this? Did I think you'd like that?
No.
Was it the right color? Does that sound like a guy who's got his mind on another girl?
No. And one of you certainly had good taste in presents, I must say. But just the same, he's been quiet and strained ever since he got here. So something must have happened. Tom. Bill, nothing happened along the road, did it?
Well, you can't prove it by me. I was asleep most of the way out here.
No, think hard.
Well, honest, nothing. I vaguely remember hearing Tom muttering to himself while he drove along, but I...
And?
Well, you know, now that I think of it, I do seem to remember a woman's voice in there a couple of times. Of course, I thought I was dreaming.
Do you remember where you heard it?
Oh, I didn't even open my eyes. All I know is we were going down a hill. We seem to have been going down a hill the whole way up here.
It was a long hill. In other words, now I know what's been the matter with Tom.
Oh, wait a minute, Lucille. If there's anything I've said...
Rest easy, Bill. But tomorrow I'm going to take Tom out for a drive, and you're not invited.
Although the roads hadn't improved a bit, Lucille insisted on going out for a drive with Tom on the following day. She took the wheel, and as the car pulled out of the village, she said...
I should be jealous, you know.
Huh?
Yes, you pick up a girl along the road, don't even tell me about it.
Wait a minute, now.
She's a beautiful girl, with eyes like nothing a man has ever seen before.
You've been talking to Bill.
And you end up at my house, walking around as though you weren't, well, quite connected with this world.
Answer me, have you been talking with Bill?
I've talked with Bill, yes, but he didn't tell me any of this.
Well, then how'd you know?
Uh-huh. That's an admission that it's all true.
Well, all right, I picked up the girl. Well, she was standing beside the road trying to flag a ride to her home. It looked pretty cold out there, so I took her home.
Yeah, but you wanted to see her again.
Well, I wanted... Well, I... Look here. Was this kid a friend of yours?
No.
Well, then how did you know all this?
I'm psychic.
Oh, nonsense.
No, really, Tom. Why the stare ever since you got here? Do you realize that you haven't looked me in the eyes once?
Well, I didn't realize them. I'm sorry, it won't happen again.
Yes, but what's your promise worth? How do I know it won't happen again?
Because I love you, and I want to marry you. You're the only girl in the world for me.
Oh. Well, that goes a long way toward getting you out of the doghouse.
Oh, that's good.
Now, if you can explain walking around with a dreamy countenance.
Well, you put your finger on it, all right. See that girl's eyes? They're what had me walking around in a trance. I just couldn't get them out of my mind.
All right, darling. Now, I'll show you how I happen to know all about it. Although, this is an advantage that I really should keep.
By a roundabout way, Lucille drove Tom to the long hill, where unexplained things had started happening to him. Different as it appeared in daylight, Tom could still recognize it, and he said so.
That's right, darling. See, now we're headed back toward my house on exactly the same road you took Christmas Eve.
Yeah.
Do you remember hearing something around this point?
Yeah, sleigh bells.
Did you see the sleigh?
No. That's what stuck me.
You didn't see the sleigh because it was traveling an old road. It doesn't exist anymore. It used to run parallel to this one, at least partway down the hill. And then, just about here, I should think, you started hearing a train whistle.
Yeah, I'm darned if I did. How did you know?
And when you came around this curve, you saw...
I saw a train.
Yes. But now... Look, in the light of day, do you see any railroad crossing there?
No. Not a sign of one. What was I, out of my head? Or...
No, darling, you were all right. Look on either side of the road. You'll see the old railroad bed where the line used to run through here.
Yeah?
And right here is where you picked up the girl, isn't it?
Yeah, she was standing right over there by that rock.
Now, Tom, the reason I know exactly what happened is that it's happened before to other people down through the years. You see, back around 1900, a girl named Ethel Wyman was hurrying down this hill in a sleigh, trying to reach her father's sickbed before he died. And she was struck and killed here by the train that used to run on this line.
Yeah, and it was painted all white, wasn't it?
And every year at Christmas time, the scene is reenacted with the girl standing by the side of the road, trying to get a ride to her father's house. And everyone who has experienced it has made a point of reporting the girl's eyes. They were haunting.
Yeah, they certainly were. Well, so I picked up a ghost and took her home, huh? See, that'll be something to remember. Look, how will you tell me why all this business is about you being jealous?
Oh, it was just too good an opportunity, sweetheart. I just wanted to be sure that you'd never look at another girl again, no matter what kind of eyes she has.
Thinking it over later, there was something that neither Tom nor Lucille could puzzle out. Before reaching Ethel Wyman's home, Tom had taken a left fork at the bottom of Long Hill, then crossed a covered bridge. Retracing that route in daylight, he found that neither the fork in the road nor the bridge existed. The road ended at an abutment, and beyond it lay Great Hollow Reservoir, built 40 years before.
Tune in at the same time for Walter Gibson, your expert on the supernatural, stories of ghosts, of spirits, werewolves, and voodoo. And each story you hear is true, but strange. Strange with Walter Gibson as your expert was directed by Bill Marshall. In the cast were Mary Patton and Hal Holbrook. This is Charles Wood speaking.